Hello, this is Charting Man Dan of The Chart Guys, where we teach the little guy and girl how to utilize charts to manage their own trades and investments. What do I mean by the little guy and girl? Well, we just had two directives signed, halting the implementation of a rule that requires financial advisors to act in the best interests of their client. Let that sink in a little bit. The big wigs on Wall Street can play with your retirement and hard-earned money without your best interests at heart. We currently have hundreds of members taking charge of their financial future, and we would love for you to come check out a free week with no credit card required to see if our services would be beneficial on your path to financial independence as well. What we offer, we have a separate course of over 5 hours in length on when to enter and exit positions. And in terms of what we do daily, we have nightly videos, key levels updated each morning before the bell, 2.5 hours of live daily webcam coverage in the morning and in the afternoon, and over 7 hours of educational videos. All of these links can be found in the description of this video. Come check us out. Thanks for watching. Let's get on to the technical analysis. Checking in on PCLN NVDA TSLA NFLX CMG on the daily weekly time frame. So we have the PCLN bulls consolidating, but it is a bull flag pattern, and the correlation to the S&P 500 is very strong, and it's the same pattern as the S&P 500 is seeing. So we've got a healthy pullback, lower wicks with bulls buying the dip, backtesting and holding the middle Bollinger Band support. That level is 1848.67, and the bulls closing closer to the high than they are to the low. So we will be looking for the potential of the bulls to show up. If we see the market bulls head to all-time highs and confirm their bull flag, we'll look for PCLN to do the same and get a bullish MACD cross. The gap to fill will be our target at 1898. So this is very healthy for the bulls at this point, and the weekly time frame is showing that the bulls are still certainly in control. As long as those exponential moving average supports hold, the bulls will maintain that control, and we're seeing the follow-through already last week off of that support holding. So bulls in full control. It would take an increase in bear volume and a close below the middle Bollinger Band and exponential supports in order to see the pattern negated. But as of right now, we are looking for continuation, and we just need the market bulls to show up to help. NVDA easily pushing through the upper wick of yesterday. That upper wick occurred on 1 5-minute candlestick. Not a lot of resistance was established at those levels, so the bulls are seeing some nice follow-through. New all-time high, little upper wick of profit-taking, not significant at this point. The bulls are pretty extended to the upside, but as we know, at blue sky breakout, the bulls can proceed in that overbought condition for quite some time. So resistance is 146.29, 147, 148. Psychological resistance levels from here. And our new base of support is down at 136.44. Weekly time frame is still above the upper Bollinger Band with the bulls in full control for the past 3 weeks. No risk of losing that at this point. That upper Bollinger Band is 139.85. And we're currently $5 above that level. So not a risk at this point. It would take significant consolidation for the rest of the week to lose that upper Bollinger Band, which would indicate consolidation is coming on a weekly time frame perspective, but not a worry of the bulls at this point. TSLA, huge bull volume, huge follow through, bull MACD cross, closing at the highs. Yet again, I keep pointing out how the bulls are able to close at these highs and give that momentum to themselves. And we saw that end of last week. Started this week, we could see pre-market right before the bell rang. It was just a bunch of bull momentum. It carried over right at the bell. We got that new all-time high, and there was no looking back. We saw over an $8 move to the upside after that all-time high was hit. Weekly time frame follow through, exponential supports holding, bulls in full control. Tesla was one of the lead bulls today, and not slowing down at the close. There was no profit taking going on, so we're looking up at 340 resistance tomorrow, and we'll see if the bulls can continue pushing up to that level. NFLX also an all-time high. Definitely saw profit taking, though, with an upper wick and a close down near the low of the day. So support is 162.71, 160.55, and then there's a gap to fill at 158.48. Bullish MACD cross underway, but this is a bearish reversal candlestick, so we do need to be cautious of consolidation. Obviously, a name like Tesla and its all-time high is way stronger than what NFLX put up today, but it is certainly a lead bull overall. Just there are other lead bulls that are stronger. There's so many all-time highs occurring in this market right now. We're trying to see the bulls are trying to see themselves close above the upper Bollinger Band of 163.29 to remain in breakout mode after closing above that level last week and ride that upper Bollinger Band continuing to show strength. But again, we do need to be cautious due to the candlestick that formed today. CMG is weak. Lower highs and lower lows continue. As soon as we broke 474, we were looking down at 470 and 465 support. The key level is 465. If we lose that level, the bears will take over in the short term as this main support that established over 3 weeks of time will have broken. And the weekly time frame shows the rejection from the 100-week resistance, potentially losing exponential support, and the bears are starting to creep in here. Still holding on for the bulls. 465 is the line in the sand for me, but watching it very close as this daily chart very clearly favors the bears short term with lower highs and lower lows and no real sign of the bulls. We haven't seen two strong green days in a row since we hit that top at 499. I appreciate you watching. We'll check back in tomorrow. See you then.